इस बिल को हम इसीलिए ले रहे हैं क्योंकि पिछले दो साल से हम लगातार कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स और स्मॉल बैंक्स जिनके डिपॉजिटर्स को बहुत तकलीफ हो रही है, उन डिपॉजिटर्स का प्रोटेक्शन के लिए और उनके इंटरेस्ट के प्रोटेक्शन के लिए और कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स जो कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज जो बैंक के नाते काम करते हैं उनमें जो बैंक के नाम उपयोग करते हैं या बैंकर या बैंकिंग के काम करते हैं उनको रेगुलेट करने के लिए इस बैंकिंग एक्ट के द्वारा, बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट अमेंडमेंट के द्वारा उनका डिपॉजिटर्स का प्रोटेक्शन के लिए ये अमेंडमेंट लिया जा रहा है। We are trying to bring this amendment in order to protect the depositors who in the last 2 years, honorable members, sir, through you I wish to say, would know that depositors in some unfortunate situations in banks or cooperative societies which are operating as banks are put to hardship, either because these banks have fallen into bad days, requiring therefore the regulator to bring a moratorium and to solve the problem seems to consume all the time. Is regulation isliye ek act ke dwara bill amendment ke dwara humne march bank budget session ke samay usko pesh kiya tha. We had introduced this bill in order to have the amendments brought in so that depositors' interest will be taken care of. But unfortunately, because during the budget session we couldn't have this bill passed, we had to bring an ordinance. And that ordinance was brought in only because, sir, the health, financial health of many of these cooperative societies which were also performing as banks was becoming very delicate. मैं सदस्यगण सबको आपके द्वारा ये जानकारी देना चाह रही हूँ कि कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स का हालात थोड़ा गंभीर होने के कारण लॉकडाउन के पीरियड होते हुए भी हमने एक ऑर्डिनेंस ले आने का मजबूर हुआ। कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स का हालात बोलने के समय मैं ये ध्यान दिलाना चाह रही हूँ कि 277 अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स का फाइनेंशियल स्टेट ऑफ अफेयर्स बहुत ही वीक है। 277 अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स लॉस रिपोर्ट कर रहे हैं। 105 अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स उनका अपना मिनिमम रेगुलेटरी कैपिटल रिक्वायरमेंट भी भरपाई नहीं कर पा रहे हैं। Meaning 105 urban cooperative banks are unable to meet even the minimum regulatory capital requirement. So 47 having negative net worth, 47 ka net worth negative hai. Fir 328 urban cooperative banks are having more than 15% gross NPA. ग्रॉस एनपीए रेशियो 15% का अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स में एनपीए होने के कारण, मैं मार्च 2019 का डेटा बोल रही हूँ, ये सब ऐसे रहते हुए मार्च 2020 तक डेटा देखिए सर, पैंडेमिक के द्वारा स्ट्रेस कोऑपरेटिव बैंक में इंक्रीज हुआ विद ग्रॉस एनपीए रेशियोज ऑफ अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स increased from 7.27% in March 2019 to over 10% in March 2020. Therefore, it was felt that in the interest of the depositors, we should have this ordinance brought in. Now, that ordinance will have to be replaced so that we are able to have three different things brought in, sir. सेक्शन 3 का अमेंडमेंट हो रही है, सेक्शन 45 का अमेंडमेंट हो रही है, सेक्शन 56 का भी अमेंडमेंट हो रही है। Now, amendments to 3 and 56 are clearly because bank ke naam rakhte hue jo bhi cooperative society function karte hain, unko commercial banks ko jo rules lagta hai, wahi rule unko bhi lagna chahiye. By amending section 3 and section 56, we are making provisions applicable. That which is applicable for banking companies, that is commercial banks, to cooperative banks also, so that cooperative banks are equally subjected to better governance and sound banking regulations through the RBI. Ye three amend section 3 ka amendment or section 56 ka amendment ka motive yehi hai, objective yehi hai. Section 45 ka bhi amendment ho rahi hai, ye kyun ho rahi hai? That will enable the RBI to make a scheme of reconstruction or amalgamation. For example, the way in which the recent Yes Bank reconstruction scheme happened to protect the interests of the public depositors. Depositors ke hit mein, agar reconstruction ho sakta hai, bina moratorium period, without making the bank undergo a moratorium period, if you're able to reconstruct the bank, if you're able to professionalize their management, and if that power can be given to the RBI, it might help the depositors so that aaj bhi main dubara wo udaran le rahi hu, PMC bank ka depositors ka solution aaj tak ho nahi pa rahi. अगर आरबीआई के पास सेक्शन 56 के द्वारा इस अमेंडमेंट के द्वारा सॉरी सेक्शन 45 इस अमेंडमेंट के द्वारा आरबीआई को हम वो पावर सौंपा देंगे, कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज जिन जिन को बैंक का नाम है सिर्फ उनको वर्तित है ये अमेंडमेंट्स. प्राइवेट सॉरी प्राइमरी एग्रीकल्चरल क्रेडिट सोसाइटी को ये लागू नहीं है. दिस डज नॉट अप्लाई. This shall not apply to the primary agricultural credit societies. This shall also not be applicable to cooperative society whose primary object and primary business is providing long-term finance for agricultural development. Inko bhi ye lagu nahi hai. So let us be clear that we are not doing anything to touch state cooperatives. We are not doing anything to touch primary agricultural credit societies. We are not doing anything to touch cooperative societies whose primary object and primary business is providing of long-term finance for agricultural development. So, agar koi member ke man mein ye shak hai ki kya ye PAC ko vartit hai, क्या ये कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज जो एग्रीकल्चरल डेवलपमेंट में काम करती हैं उनको भी टच करेगा, मैं आश्वासन दिलाना चाह रही हूँ माननीय स्पीकर महोदय आपके द्वारा कि ये बिल्कुल इनको वर्तित नहीं होगा. सिर्फ इनको वर्तित होगा जो बैंक या बैंकर या बैंकिंग का काम करते हैं कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज में, सिर्फ उनको ही लागू होगा. एंड ये पहले बार नहीं है इस सेक्शन को अमेंडमेंट करने का सरकार के द्वारा प्रयत्न हुआ है. सेक्शन 3 का 56 का अमेंडमेंट इससे पहले भी हुआ है, इसीलिए कोई ये ना गलतफहमी में रहे कि ये क्या हो रही है, इस बार क्यों ऐसे कर रहे हैं. इससे पहले भी सेक्शन 3 और सेक्शन 56 का अमेंडमेंट भी हुआ है, एक बार 68 में, 65 में, 1965 में, 1984 में, 1987 में, 1989 में और 2012 में भी इन सेक्शन का अमेंडमेंट हुआ है. सो इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ मैं इस बिल का कंसिडरेशन लेने के लिए आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करती हूँ.
द फाइनल पॉइंट दैट आई वुड लाइक टू स्ट्रेस एंड अंडरस्कोर मिस्टर स्पीकर सर इज दैट द रिकॉर्ड ऑफ द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया विद रिगार्ड टू being able to preempt malfeasance or what is colloquially called scams in the banking sector is very mixed. I do not want to belabor that Yes Bank, the Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank, the Island FS, Divan Housing, to name a few of the instances of malfeasance which have taken place when these institutions were under the superintendence, the direct superintendence of the Reserve Bank of India. May I humbly submit, Mr. Speaker, sir, that the Reserve Bank of India in itself is a conflicted institution by design. It is the regulator of the banks, it is the investment banker of the government, it is the owner, operator, regulator and player in the bond market, it is the manager of the government's credit and monetary policies, it is the foreign exchange regulator, and it is the currency regulator, and the list goes on, and it is endless. If there is a need to bring about substantive reform, the need is to unscramble this egg called the Reserve Bank of India and segregate its various functions by spinning them off into different instrumentalities so that the primary function of the Reserve Bank of India, that is the regulator of the Indian banking system, can be properly discharged. My humble appeal, Mr. Speaker, sir, through you to the Honorable Finance Minister is, let's leave the cooperative sector alone. If there have been instances of malfeasance in district cooperative central banks, in urban local cooperative banks, there are as many success stories, if not more, which have played themselves out over the past seven decades. State governments are more than competent to discharge their function, and in a federal polity, this ordinance and the bill which seeks to replace it, Mr. Speaker, sir, is a frontal assault on the federal structure of the Constitution, and this will have long-term implications on the democratic polity of India. May I once again, through you, Honorable Speaker, sir, urge the Honorable Finance Minister to withdraw this bill and let this ordinance be disapproved by a statutory resolution. Otherwise, this House will be witness to another blow which is being dealt through federalism, and which I earlier stated would have long-term implications on the polity of this country.
Under this Act, it gave powers to the Reserve Bank of India, the power to license banks, sir. The second objective was to have regulation over shareholding and voting of the shareholders, sir. The third one was supervise the appointment of boards and the management. And the fourth, to regulate the operations of banks and lay down instructions for audits. And fifth was control, moratorium, merger and liquidation. And the sixth was to issue direction in the interest of public good and banking policy. And the final, the seventh objective was of the main act was to impose a penalty on banks if required, sir. So in the year 1965, till those times, the cooperative banks were not part of this Banking Regulation Act. It was amended to include the cooperative banks under its purview by adding sections 56. So what the Honorable Finance Minister was telling us, it was the section 56. Under the section 56, the cooperative banks were added into this BR Act, sir. As the economic situation arising from the COVID-19 pandemic has increased the stress in both in cooperative and banking companies, there was an immediate need for legislation in this regard. As the Honorable Finance Minister already has said, the certain amendments were considered necessary in the said Act to provide for better management and proper regulation of cooperative banks and ensure affairs of the banks are conducted in a manner to protect the interest of depositors by increasing professionalism and enabling them to raise capital and improve the governance and ensure sound banking under the supervision of Reserve Bank of India.
The register of cooperative banks is already there in the states to appoint RBI as the total regulator is a wrong step. And he has also mentioned that RBI is overloaded. Sir, so the question arises as to why did the government bring this bill in a hurry? The main trigger was the collapse of the Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. Large number of people were depositors were put to difficulty, and the RBI imposed significant restrictions on withdrawal and suspended its business. Now these depositors of PNC Bank, they demonstrated before the finance minister when she went to Bombay. So she thought that I must do something, otherwise I'll face demonstrations whenever I go to Mumbai.
The Honorable Finance Minister, in her speech of the 2020 budget speech, said that she is soon going to bring an act to strengthen and professionalize cooperative banks, basically in order to protect the interests of depositors and to strengthen cooperative banks by improving governance and oversight, which is sorely and long overdue. The idea is for allowing the RBI to initiate reconstruction or amalgamation of a bank without an order of moratorium. The ordinance and the now current bill obviously seeks to avoid any disruption of the financial system. This cleanup of the cooperative bank space is obviously very welcome, and my party heartily supports the Honorable Finance Minister.
That will positively impact the lives of more than 20 crore depositors of urban cooperative banks, district central cooperative banks, and state cooperative banks, whose lives and life savings were under jeopardy because of a regulatory twilight zone. That cooperative banks are in a precarious state, owing primarily to unprofessional management and non-compliance with modern banking practices, is beyond dispute. When these banks crumble under their own weight, helpless depositors are left to fend for themselves without much effective legal redress. We have seen how in the recent past, thousands of depositors, primarily from modest middle-class backgrounds and lower middle-class backgrounds, have been defrauded. The PMC Bank case in Mumbai and the Sri Guru Raghavendra Cooperative Bank case in my own constituency of Bangalore is a case in point.
These provisions go against the tenets of cooperative movement and cooperative societies registered under the West Bengal Cooperative Societies Act 2006 as amended. Raising of shares by way of public issue or private placement is not provided for in the West Bengal Cooperative Societies Act 2006. It is a corporate concept where ownership is determined by the number of shares held. WBCS Act 2006 provides for one member, one vote. There is also a prescribed ceiling on holding of shares under the West Bengal Cooperative Societies Act. Moreover, there is no provision for issuing unsecured debentures by the cooperative societies in the WCS Act. Also, as per WCS Act, bonds cannot be issued without the prior approval of the state government. But this banking regulation ordinance provides for public issue of private placement of bonds. Therefore, it takes away the rights of the state government.
Sir, pehle, I want to make it very clear that this bill does not provide for regulation of cooperative banks by the central government. Ye bill bilkul ye amendment ka matlab nahi hai ki Kendra Sarkar sabhi cooperative bank ke upar nigrani rakhegi. Amendment iske liye nahi hai. Galat fehmi nahi hona chahiye. दूसरा, ये कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स का आज क्या हो गया, आपने क्यों रेगुलेशन करके आरबीआई के हाथ में सौंपना चाह रहे हैं? क्षमा कीजिए सर, कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स का रेगुलेशन आरबीआई के द्वारा 1965 से ऑलरेडी हो रही है. हम नया कुछ नहीं कर रहे हैं, मगर कुछ नया जो कर रहे हैं वो डिपॉजिटर्स के हित में लिए हित के लिए कर रहे हैं. So this bill does not regulate the cooperative banks. The amendment is not for the central government to take over cooperative banks or to control the cooperative banks. And it is not for the first time that this regulation of extending some powers to the RBI is happening. Since 1965, cooperative banks are already being regulated by the RBI. वो दूसरी पॉइंट रखना चाह रही हूँ सर, क्योंकि बहुत सारे वरिष्ठ मेंबर ने इसका तरह तरह से जिक्र किए हैं। तीसरी, ये स्टेट का अधिकार के लिए उल्लंघन है, आप इसमें कैसे आपके पैर रख रही हो, ये स्टेट फेडरलिज्म का रिस्पेक्ट नहीं करता है वगैरह। पार्लियामेंट का कॉम्पिटेंसी इस विषय को लेजिस्लेट करने का बिल्कुल है, क्योंकि हम बैंकिंग के एक्टिविटी को रेगुलेट करना चाह रहे हैं जो एंट्री नंबर 45 में है, इसलिए नया नहीं कुछ नहीं कर रहे हैं। रिकॉल फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस हाउस दैट द प्रीएम्बल ऑफ द आरबीआई एक्ट सेक्शन 45L(1) इन ब्रैकेट सेज Reserve Bank of India Act provides for the RBI and recognizes the RBI as the statutory body, and it is statutorily constituted to operate and empowered to regulate the credit system of the country to its advantage. So entire country ka credit system ko regulate karne ka authority as per the preamble of the RBI Act is with the RBI. So when we are bringing this bill, our stand is the Registrar of Cooperative Society regulates the cooperative societies as a whole, cooperative societies as a whole, while the RBI shall be regulating the banking activities of the cooperative societies only. So the distinction is very clear.